This is my Echo. Got it for Christmas. I'm going to set it up. This is not an official unboxing or anything. I'm literally just have you sat on my lap. But from everything I've heard, these are a lot of fun. There's buttons up top. A little plus, minus. I guess that's a mute button. Hefty plug. This is the cover, and then the aux audio. Oh, there's an audio out button. I guess if you can plug her into something else, it's like right. The little switch right here. Oh, hello. Oh, hello. Hello there. That hurt. But that's because I have nails, so you just push it off. Why would I want to do that? Why is this important? Slide back in. Okay, we're going to download the app and plug it in. Plug it in. Hello? Are you listening to me?
Hello. Your Amazon Echo is ready for setup. Just follow the instructions in your Alexa app.
Well, I'm going to set up Alexa now, and if I find anything interesting, I'll let you all know.
Hey guys, so this is my second time filming this clip, which I'm not happy about because the first set just looked horrible. So, I also don't know what I put in front of this video, but here is my quick review of the Echo Dot and the Echo Amazon Echo speaker. So we got it back in January, we got it for Christmas this last year, and we loved it so much that we decided to get one for each room. We have the Amazon Echo, which is the tall speaker one. We have the Echo Dot, the very first one, which is super tiny, and then we got the Echo Dot, I think it's 2, might be 3, but it's the larger one that has a much nicer speaker on it. We use it, the most that we use it for is for our shopping list and for our routines. For example, which everything is customizable, and I highly recommend if you get one of these that you download the app. I think you can actually download the app and explore what you can do with her anyway, like without getting her or before you get her. If you use Amazon a lot, I highly recommend you use her. She is smarter than Siri. We've tested this out several times, and I think it's even proven that she is smarter than Siri. But for our routines is what we use it the most, specifically our morning and nighttime routine. Morning routine, under routines in the app, you can pick whatever tasks you want her to do, which there are so many different things that she can do. For example, I think we have her say good morning, she turns on the lights for us, and then she tells us our schedule, because you can have it connect to your Apple account to have your contacts and your calendar. And so she's connected to like my calendar. Tells us what's on the calendar, and then she tells us a fun fact about the day, the weather, and then she plays. We used to have her connected, or we used to have her play one of my Spotify playlists because I connected her to my Spotify, but now I have her use the radio, which she can play music on Apple Music and using the radio with an app called TuneIn. And it costs you absolutely nothing. Like if I didn't have Spotify connected to her, she would still use Apple Music to play things. It's just she wouldn't use like playlists. Whereas like Spotify, I have all my different playlists. But I love, love, love using her routines also and her reminders because I'll always forget to do things. And a lot of times if I set something on my phone, I'll forget to do it. Whereas if I tell her to do it, she's gonna go nuts telling me to do it until I tell her to stop. For the shopping list, my husband and I use Amazon Prime now, and because she's connected to Amazon, whenever we add things to the shopping list, which is as easy as saying her name and say, add bread to the shopping list, and she'll add it to the shopping list. So when I go into my Amazon Prime Now app, at the very bottom, it gives me a list of everything that I need to do, and I can check each one off, which I absolutely love, because a lot of times my husband and I forget to add things, so as soon as we something go out of it or like we throw it away or whatever, we just say her name and to add it like right then and there. What else is something? Oh, and for like our nighttime routine, we have her like turn off all the lights, tell us good night, and then she plays like a bedtime playlist for us. But when it comes to the lights, she does hook up to, I believe, most smart devices. Double check whenever you're purchasing one just to make sure it says that it is Echo usable. Typically, most are. The lights that, because we live in an apartment, the lights that we have set up are actual smart plugs. They're individual plugs, and each one's connected to like a lamp, like this one. Or we have Christmas lights that go down the hallways. You can kind of see in the corner of this video. And so each one has a different name. If I unplug this one and I wanted to move this lamp, say, on the other side of the room, it would still have the same name. Very easy to set up. All of this is very easy to set up because it uses the Wi-Fi. They all talk to each other. But I love it. It's super, super easy. I listen to music more often than I used to before, like when I'm cooking in the kitchen. Even my Echo or my Echo Dot that I have in my office, that's connected via Bluetooth, a larger speaker that I have behind my desk. And so it goes from like the crappiest speaker in the apartment to like a best speaker in the apartment. She'll play music from pretty much anything, from any artist. The only issue that I typically find is that she has issues shuffling things. So if you have a playlist, she's going to play it in the order that it is. But if you're using Spotify or I guess Apple Music as well, you can go in and just tap on the shuffle button and she will shuffle it for you. it's helpful to connect it to like a phone versus say like I'm filming on my iPad right now, just because it has like location. And you're probably thinking, why would I want her to know my location, my contacts and everything? I can text from her, and when I like come home, she senses when I'm home and she can remind me of things when I come home. Because sometimes I come home from work at different times and I want her to remind me when I come home. And so if she reminds me too early, I don't get it. If she reminds me too late, like I may be doing something else that I can't do, whatever it is. So if I remind her when I come in through the door, she's like, this is what you should be doing. Which I love the reminders because I forget to do things so much when I plan things on my phone versus when I tell her to do it, she goes nuts and I'm like, oh, I gotta get up and I gotta do that. But, it's so easy to use. The app has so many different games and things, tasks that you can teach her, like games and other skills. I just learned when I was filming the first time that she can actually read you. From what I can see, that she can, under the play section, because she connects to your Audible account and your Spotify, she has access to your Kindle library. And from what I can tell, I don't think it's all books, because I only see two out of the several books that I actually do have in Kindle. She can actually read you, it's like loading all of my books, she can actually read you your books, your stories. It's like loading all of them. Apparently I have a shared account with my mom. She has a lot more books on there than I do. But that is something that's really cool. But anyway, I highly recommend getting this. Whether you want to get a small Echo Dot for your dorm or if you want to get like a larger speaker. I do suggest if you don't have any like really good music speakers, specifically ones that connect to Bluetooth, then get the big Echo, Amazon Echo. But if you have smaller Bluetooth speakers, just get the cheaper one because they'll connect it instantaneously. Or if you want something small and you don't want something big and expensive as the tall one, get the Echo Dot 3 because the speaker on that's pretty good as well. We have that one in our bedroom to play music for us. But highly recommend it. Totally not sponsored. I just love tech, and this was a relatively cheap. I mean, we didn't buy the big Amazon one, but we bought the smaller ones, and those were not that expensive. Neither were the smart plugs. The smart plugs were not expensive either. And yeah, that's all, guys. That's all, folks. thank you all so much for watching. If you have an Amazon Echo, I almost said like. Tell me what, I keep looking at her, making sure she's not listening. Tell me what are some of your favorite things to do, or if you have any questions about it, please let me know below and I'll answer them to the best of my ability. I'm not an expert on her. I'm still learning everything about her, but thank you all so much for watching and I'll see you in the next one.